Nationals is the best regatta of the year. It's always the best parties, the best competition, the best boats.
Well, I think it's just a great opportunity for the guys from the East to sail against the guys from the West.
It's a very different experience sailing at Nationals.
So many boats. So many boats. And it's a big party. And it's kind of the culmination of everyone's practice.
We have a tremendous fleet. The competition is a really high level, and you know, it's hard to win. So it's really fun sailing. Everybody's really good out here.
There's obviously a ton of good sailors in this class, and
quite a fleet, terrific group of people. Little Egg Harbor is, in my opinion, the best venue anywhere in the country.
Best sailing place on the East Coast, I think.
Great thing about this regatta too is as soon as we're finished sailing and we've had a couple black pearls, it's off to surfing we go just across the street down the beach.
The Jersey Shore. It's a little crowded, but I like it. I like being able to go to the beach. Yeah, I went for a run yesterday. It was so fun, just to like get your mind off of it.
Yeah, I did not expect New Jersey to look like this, because the only thing I've seen about New Jersey is Trenton one time, and then Sopranos and Jersey Shore. So it's a lot nicer than what those sort of give you the impression of, you know? It's like Indiana, they think there's nothing but cornfields, and New Jersey, you think there's nothing but Sopranos and Snooki.
We're from Indianapolis. Okay. And we came, we've been here a number of Nationals in a row to Little Egg Harbor, because it is just such a wonderful place to come.
Oh, Beach Haven's great. You got big open water, no motorboats to bother you, always got wind, lots of room, good people, good hospitality. You can't ask for anything more.
It's a beautiful day in Beach Haven.
Yeah, baby.
Yeah, baby.
You are driving me nuts.
Okay. Well, let me tell you about the program.
I got my head up something.
Weather in 7 is it's gonna be shit out. Wet, come on, bear. Hi.
I'm going to introduce the people who came with me and who we go around and do different events, but you know, I'm basically, the PRO is going to be really a triumphant of the three of us. It's going to be myself and Jeff and Jim. So if there's anything to blame, you know, it gets fanned out among the three of us.
All right, this is the day before the start of Nationals. The race committee is meeting here. We have some weather fronts coming through. The weather has been a bit rainy, but hopefully we'll fit everything in the patches of clear weather.
They're trying to steal my sail tape like they've done the past two regattas. That's why they're beating
me. Listen, everything is on his boat is fair game. We're going after all of it, including him.
This is my brother, Vincent Porter, and we're just talking a little trash because he can get in his head very easily. So duly noted to all the participants.
He's very fragile. His weakness is mental mind games.
I don't know, some of my gear has suspiciously gone missing over the years. To name a few, 2 rolls of spinnaker tape, my Aigley sailing boots. The only person who borrows those is my brother.
We've been sailing with the same team all year long. Pete Strothman, our skipper, and Corbett, my cousin, who does middle, and then I do bow. So yeah, 3, you know, I used to sail with Vincent there. We've been, what was our best finish in Nationals? 2nd?
Third year, 10 years.
Third year, 10.
So what happened between you and Vincent?
Yeah. We can say the same. I used to crew for him.
Yeah,
as well.
We both did. We both kind of stopped sailing for a little bit, got a bit burnt out. He got a new crew, and then Pete moved to Geneva from Minnesota and was looking for a crew, and we were ready to get back into it. So,
how you doing?
Oh my God. Jeez. I got my head up something.
How you doing? What are you?
Rick Turner.
Pete Slack.
Hi. Good to meet you. How are you?
What are you working on?
We're just on making sure the vang is untangled.
I'm working on the vang system. We just realized one of our blocks right here was broken, so that's why it wasn't really working correctly this past bay day. So now I'm just going through the other side and making sure that everything's working smoothly and nothing's gonna break or is broken.
Well, the gorilla in the boat always stands on the bailers, so I'm gonna grease them up so they don't leak.
We're setting up the mast right now. We want to just check our rake mark, so which we forgot to do when the mast was down.
All right, go ahead. I don't think we're going.
This is putting the sock back in.
So our issue is there's a Harkin block at the top of the mast where the spinnaker runs through. Carl does such a good job at ripping our chute down that we burn through them fairly regularly. Now, we're debating whether we tip the boat over or take the mast down to replace that block.
We were going to go out and practice. I think the weather is kind of closed out. The wind has closed out for us.
There's some nice thunderstorm line coming this way. Mm-hmm. Should be here in about 15 or 20 minutes.
Right.
And I'm glad my boat's put together. Everybody else is going to get wet.
Extended tomorrow, into tomorrow, I think we're going to have a great thing. Once this front blows through, I think we're going to be looking at a northerly breeze, probably in the 18 knot area. I think it's going to pretty much blow the dogs off the chains.
So I think the harbor skipper's meeting's 8:45, 9:30 harbor gun, and 11 o'clock start is what I read on the instructions. Number of races per day will be flexible. Maybe they're going to do 331, sorry, or 3-2-2.
And you got a pretty cool showing from a lot of different.
A great showing from all over the country, as far west as Minnetonka. And I don't know if we have a Colorado boat here or not.
Yes, you do.
Oh, okay. Well, there we go.
GL-17.
GL-17, there's a Colorado, Grand Lake.
Yep.
My name's Ed Furry, sailing on GL-17 out of Grand Lake, Colorado.
Island Heights Yacht Club.
Minnetonka Yacht Club.
Chautauqua Lake.
We're from Crystal Lake, Michigan.
Lake Geneva, Wisconsin.
Crystal Lake.
Lake Geneva.
Little Egg Harbor.
Tom's River Yacht Club.
From White Bear Lake, Minnesota.
So we're from White Lake, Michigan, which is about 45 minutes north.
Give him the flex. Show him the... There you go.
Grand Lake, Colorado.
We're from Madison.
I'm from Minneapolis.
White Bear Yacht Club, Minnesota.
We sail out of Charleston. I actually live on Lake Murray, which is home of the E-Scows in South Carolina. 12-hour drive. We come up here for down bays. Been up here for nationals before. Love sailing at Little Egg.
I grew up on White Bear, and my mom sailed, my uncle and my aunts, and the whole family grew up sailing scows and X-boats and opties, so we just kind of grew into it. And, you know, it's White Bear is where scows are invented, and we're pretty proud of that, and always excited to keep sailing these boats. And the cooler they get, you know, they add the bowsprit, they add the snuffer, and the boats are still faster than ever.
Get the jury rigging in the program.
I worked all night. Was eager, couldn't sleep. I was eager to come see Harry. And Harry, we have a yin yang team, East meets West this year. Half of our normal team and half of a team from the Midwest. And all shimmer at heart.
Turn around.
No.
Turn around.
No. I'll talk for her. How's it going?
We just pulled in from Crystal Lake Yacht Club, about a 14-hour ride, but glad to be here at Little Egg, and I've been racing with Rob Terry for a lot of years. So
on the Black Pearl.
Down here, we're usually getting some good breeze, so you know, we're excited, and I think the team's ready to go. Yeah, we're hoping to have a couple good races and you know, do what we can out there and kind of hopefully surprise some people.
12-13. Yesterday we were stuck behind a school bus on the parkway, and today we're stuck behind a lot of boats.
North northwest?
No, north northeast.
Yes. What's low tide?
Low tide? Unfortunately, it's
2:45.
This afternoon.
2:45.
All these boats come back.
So the water's going to be going out to the inlet. Boys got to take a starboard tack.
Okay, we're going to run at least 3 races today. We're expecting winds to be around 12, and we'll have all these boats out of the water by 4:30 this afternoon.
The best of the best.
Hey, hey. Close up with call. E-Scow Nationals 2015. Got my gloves.
Are you sailing?
M87, Derek Packard, Minnetonka. Right. Port
look
approach.
Good, feel good kind of
the port approach boat.
You just kind of bid out to the highest bidder. Sorry about that.
Yeah, you know.
The highest bidder kind of gets your services?
Friends helping friends. I'm all about the friends helping friends.
It's friends helping friends. No
Definitely.
Money. No money was exchanged.
No money was exchanged. That would be nice, but you know, we'll see what I can pull off.
Next time.
Next time.
And you're sailing with?
Dickie White.
Right.
Quick Dick.
Oh yes. Oh yes.
Now are you sailing, are you skipping too, or are you just crewing?
Crewing this time.
Crew.
Flying the kite.
Yeah.
I know, taking a break from the tillers.
Check
that out. Yeah, we're ready to go. We're excited. We've got 18 miles an hour according to the PRO, so we're going to get locked and loaded here, and should be a great drag race.
It's going to be a great day. I'm looking forward to the air. That's going to be the best part.
You guys do good in heavy air?
Yeah, we do. I think we have a good time. I think we can hold down the boat, and we're getting comfortable with it. So, looking forward to a good time.
Do you know what your skipper's name used to be?
Flipper? I was on the boat during then, too.
Oh, you were?
Yeah. Been over twice in the same day before.
Really?
It's an interesting... 3 times? Oh, man.
1992, Lake Minnetonka. Flipped 3 times, but never in a race.
I've been here almost every time since 75, sailing the Little League. Love it.
I'd say sailing out here, boat speed is much more critical than it is on the race courses we sail on. You know, getting in a long lane and letting your boat go is what it's all about when you're out on a race course like this, as opposed to, you know, just being the first one on all the shifts and stuff like that. You know, in our lake sailing, we might have half a dozen to a dozen shifts on a leg. Out here, you might have 3, you know, so it's a big difference.
Can't wait to be on the line with 60 other boats. It's definitely a different type of racing. We're not used to being able to make 2 tacks up the lake. So hopefully we're a little more practiced and better attacking than everyone else, but we'll see.
How are you feeling?
Great. Fabulous.
Now, you just kind of hang out up here and the crew kind of just does all
the
work.
They're right over here doing all the work.
Tough job back here.
How are you?
All right, we're good to go, Randy. Let's roll.
How are we doing? Are we all ready to go?
We are. Completely ready.
He's
to
the
go.
Boss guy.
As soon as he gets his Windex tied up, we're good.
Can somebody tell me about the wind conditions? I mean, are we worried? Are we hopeful?
We're never worried.
Nice wind right now. Supposed to die as we go up. The day goes along, so that's a good thing.
Right.
Yeah. Perfect right now, probably.
Okay.
This is my 25th anniversary in the kitchen.
Wow.
Time to move on to a new job.
Everybody enjoyed breakfast and they're all good to go, right?
Yeah, we had 3 kinds of sandwiches, pork roll, egg and cheese, Jersey style, right. Bacon, egg and cheese, and egg and cheese. It's good.
Wow.
Get a hot breakfast at Little Egg.
Thank you.
here.
Thank you. showing of committee boat live.
1 minute.
How you doing?
good, you?
Good.
What do you want?
What?
What?
This is a great opportunity to see sailing friends and you know, reminisce, but then tell war stories and tell each other about our day. That's what this is about, you know, the fun of comradeship.
Harvey and I have been friends down here for a lot of years.
At least 15.
Well, 15. I've been coming for 50.
Well, I've been here for 27.
Yeah.
I'm a lot younger than you.
It's hard to believe Harvey is 92 years old.
Right.
And he soaks in formaldehyde every right. single night.
Yeah, I know.
But he smells a little bit.
Yeah, right.
I didn't sail the first race, but I'm looking forward to sailing tomorrow on I-7 with my father and his friends.
We did okay. The first race wasn't too hot, but the second race was good. It got really light, and so we were pretty heavy. We were heavy four in light air.
You got some fat guys on the
set? Yeah.
We had an okay first race, and then a really good second race. Really figured it out. And then the third race, you know, we got caught on the left side, which wasn't very good. And we missed the first shift, and it was over from there.
The races today were really fun, really tricky out there. I think the current had a big play on it. The right end side of the line and of the course was really favored all day, and it was pretty strange.
It was tricky. It was really up and down. We kind of were on a downward trend, unfortunately. We started our first race, ran the first mark in fourth, and that was awesome, and then we kind of fell down a little bit, but you know, we hung last year. We were pretty deep after the first day of Nationals, and this is our second Nationals as a boat, and we're doing pretty well.
There was current, I think, that a lot of people didn't notice, but we played the current and made some big gains. We had a tough time starting today, so we were in the back, but we did well. We had one top 10 finish. That was a lot of fun.
We had a pretty good day. Started out a little slow and then got better throughout the day. We had a 23, a 5, and a 6.
We had a lot of wind the first race, probably 15, 16 knots. It seemed to right paid a little bit. We had a good first leg and didn't pay off for us the second leg and fell back a little bit, but still a good day.
It was very shifty, yes. And I think it was great sailing and nice breeze and it eased and it was good committee work.
The racing today, I mean, first of all, first time we've all sailed together, right? So that was actually pretty cool. Great to have Shimmer back out on the water. That was also pretty cool. But having Harry 3 and 4 sitting next to them was great. Felt fast. The boat definitely felt fast. And yeah, we got 2 seconds and a fourth and felt like we were dialing in, and it was just good calm vibe on the boat and always felt like we were gaining. So yeah, it was good racing.
There's way more traffic at any mark rounding you're doing, and so everything is just a little bit crazier, but it's a lot of fun.
It was a lot of fun. It was really good, like it was good distances, it was really just a great time. 3 races was the perfect number, and it was beautiful water. You don't get this kind of clear water at Bardica Bay, so it was really nice.
Today wasn't a very good day for me. Couldn't really start, and then the one time we did start, we went to the wrong side.
Breeze went back and forth all day, really big oscillations. They actually changed the course pretty much every leg. A lot of whistles, a lot of flags, a lot of marks, 90 degrees from where the last one was, but still upwind.
So it turns out on the first race, we went to the wrong side twice.
You could get the wrong side once, not twice. Twice was the wrong move.
Usually you want to figure out your mistakes sooner than that.
After the second time picking the wrong side, Stu said, you know, maybe we ought to think about what we're doing, and so the third time we went right. Of course, that was the wrong way to go, too. So.
You know, I haven't ever seen a day quite like it where the right was so favored, I guess. I've sailed in a really close wind direction, but without the clouds, when it seemed to me in the past the left was favored. And that worked for me a lot of times in the past, and it was just a little different condition, and you know, it took us a while to figure it out that you just had to be right. But T73 had it figured out pretty well.
I think, we started kind of middle boat every race and tried to lead to the right every single beat, and so that was the way to go, and it certainly worked. Obviously, I mean, we've had good boat speed the last few weeks, and you know, that's really it. I think we, you know, when it's kind of bouncy and, you know, puffy like that, I have a great crew, and they do a good job of keeping the boat rolling and really steady, and I think that gives us good boat speed. So anytime we were kind of bumping up and down like everyone else, we just had better speed than everyone.
We got pork roll, egg, cheese, and I'm waiting for my bagel to come up. I mean, we don't have this thing called pork roll in Minnesota, but I guess that's all they eat out here. It looks pretty good to me, though.
The pork roll's key. You need the pork roll every morning.
There you go. Thanks. Looking good. Need the Bloody Mary.
We're feeding 284 people, sailors and volunteers.
We have 75 dozen eggs. What do we have? 60 pounds of pork roll, 60 pounds of sausage, 60 pounds of bacon, 400 pounds of potatoes.
Are you ready for those eggs there, Lovey?
Yep, we're almost there. 6 gallons of Pepto-Bismol.
I did hear someone say they had acid reflux yesterday.
The key to my eggs are chickens, right? It all starts with a chicken.
Regatta-wide, we have over 100 volunteers. In the kitchen, we have about 40. They come and go. We have some that start the very beginning. I was here at 4 a.m. this morning. Generally, we start at 6, so we can have coffee and something to eat by 7. And we give them as much as we possibly can. It's great. They love it. It's a great place to sail. They love being here.
Looks like a good day, and we have some bad weather moving in, but I think we're in the Beach Haven bubble, so it might go around us. The Beach Haven bubble is actually, historically, storms come from the mainland and they hit the bay out here, and they either go north or south because of the winds. I don't know if there's any truth, scientific truth to it, but I've seen it happen many times.
So it's a little bit like the triangle over in Bermuda.
Well, we haven't lost any boats out there yet, but the storms do go north and south of here, and sometimes they avoid us completely. So we'll have thunderstorms north of us and thunderstorms south of us.
Wow, what's in that coffee?
A little bit of bourbon, a little wild turkey, some banana, and what else did we put in this?
And I'm gonna drive.
Yeah,
a lot of protein. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's gonna be a long day of hiking.
What did you have for breakfast this morning?
I had toast.
That's it?
And some cinnamon croissants.
Nice.
Very good.
That's a nice choice. What's the secret today? I mean, what's your strategy? You're the tactician, right?
Yeah. Well, it's a south. The sea breeze is gonna come in out of the southeast. So you just gotta sail to the puffs and connect them. That's how you're gonna win.
Gotta get it together today.
You're gonna get some eggs.
It fell apart. We're gonna go get a pork roll, egg, and cheese, and that'll fire me up and get rid of some of the residual alcohol.
Boys, good. All right. Well, good luck.
I pull a banana. 1-1-1.
A lot of people out there want to know what does he eat? What does this guy eat?
Nothing special, just eggs and toast, man. That's it.
Dry white toast, or, you know, you put butter on it?
Oh, big, big slab of butter.
Here we go. Yesterday was a really fun day of sailing. We improved all day. We sailed backwards a little bit in the first two races, but then had a solid second place in the last race. So we got to have 3 good ones today and see what we can do.
It was like we were there, and then we were gone. And then we were there, and then we were gone. So hopefully today we're more there.
Yesterday was fun. It's good, some good rides.
Right.
Got a good start.
Right.
Can't complain. Hopefully we keep moving in the up direction.
Yesterday was shifty and puffy, and which is the normal conditions we sail in, so we should have had a better day yesterday, and just did not ever hit the correct side of the course or do the right things yesterday. So today we're hoping it's a little better day. We're a little bit heavy for a crew weight, and it should blow a little harder today, so we're excited about that.
How was yesterday?
Up and down. I met everybody in the fleet. They're from the front to the back. They're my good friends now. I was 5th in the first race, 50th in the second race, and then 16th in the next race. So there wasn't anybody I didn't communicate with.
We've been arguing all summer. This is the argument. I feel that I need to hike less, but I can motivate, coach him to hike harder as he's bigger. And I think overall we will keep the boat flatter. But his opinion is...
Since I'm bigger,
right? I think I should hike less, because me hiking less is doing the same amount as him hiking more.
Right.
What's the dilemma? I mean, that is
what do you think?
The question of the summer.
Pinbo, we'll probably wait 5 minutes and then set you up. Let's go ahead and set the mark at 160, over.
Pinbo, radio check 66, over.
Copy that. We've been seeing a little left of what you've been seeing, but I think we're a little bit under a cloud over here.
This is an I over Z flag start. Repeat, there's an ebb pushing you over the line. You've got to set deeper into the spot. Drop the general recall flag. Please keep in mind there is an ebb tide and the whole leeward end was over by a mile.
Thank you.
much inside of the course. We can't find the marks because the whole fleet of boats in front of it.
Your course is port number five. Bearing to the weather mark 130. Port number five.
Set up in the box.
Thank you.
cake.
Wow, look at those things.
I hope this is where I'm going.
Pretzel.
Pretzels. Mustard. You can't beat it. And they were warm. That's the bonus.
Now this is Philadelphia.
While the boat is waiting to get hauled out, I get the beers for the boys.
One, two, three, five nuggets.
Right, and then you got
only three beers.
Right, who's listening?
I should get the two more beers then, I guess.
Oh, we didn't do too well having with traffic management today. Shifts we were okay, boat speed we were okay, but traffic management was a bit of a nightmare.
Right.
I looked up at the leeward mark one time and there was a guy right between the marks coming upwind and there was about six of us going downwind. And amazingly, nobody hit anybody and it was interesting.
We had a bit of contact out there and I want to compliment Melgus on making a solid boat, okay? There was no sign of that contact. All right.
We sailed around, we tacked a few times, did a couple jives.
We went upwind sometimes, a couple downwinds. We started twice.
Right. Can you be any more generic?
This is a pretty generic interview, so I like to keep it on point.
No.
Can you put a couple more pretzels in your mouth before I ask you the next question?
Sure.
The races today were pretty good, despite the second one where we were gone most of it with no bang, but that's how it goes sometimes.
We had a good day today, better than yesterday. Not as well as we would have liked to have been, but we had a good day.
I hate when you do this.
You know, the breeze comes down, the waves still up pretty high.
Yeah.
And you gotta change gears and keep the bow down, and we had a tough time doing that, I think. You know, the wind was up and down. It was a little more, it would go up a little higher than yesterday and then drop a little more. So it was a little more, you know, the peaks were higher and then the lows were much lower. Yesterday was kind of more consistent, I thought. And today, I think it was just about switching gears. Especially dealing with those waves and just staying out in clear air and staying in phase.
Today was a really good day, much more solid day.
Right.
The problem is if you're not in the lead, it's very hard to get back up there.
Right.
It's just such a big fleet.
The size of the fleet frustrates you because if you don't get a good start, you're kind of screwed.
Once you get in the back, it's just tough to get out. It's hard to find a clean lane. And it's you just get pinballed around. You want to go a certain way and you can't because somebody tacks on you. There's just nowhere to go. So you just got to, you know, do your best to try and get out of there and find a clean lane and get going.
We had a great first race going, and we just overshot the weather mark.
What's it like going out this far at the first race?
I overshot the mark by a mile. Yeah, you heard me? There were words being said. And it was basically, I'm going to blame this guy. So this guy said we were two-thirds up the beat. We had two-thirds to go and to the ley line. And when he said that, we should attack because we were so far overstood, it was ridiculous.
That's true. What he just said is accurate.
We had a better race the second race. We lost a couple boats on the last beat, which was upsetting, but we're fairly pleased with today compared. I feel much better to coming in off the water today than I did yesterday. Put it that way.
Go back a little farther, okay, Dave?
Yep.
Watch the boom.
Yeah, you guys do this. I'll pick it.
What are you doing back there? We're just laughing. It's Friday, Sunday morning. What day is it? We're just having a good time, Pete.
Yep.
Sunday morning, some beautiful sailing all weekend long. Hanging with good friends. It really doesn't get any better.
We're just talking about how great E-Scow sailing is.
Absolutely. It's
you know,
wonderful to be here.
His wife has a twin sister and she's my next door neighbor at Lake Geneva, so I get the pleasure of seeing Rick at, you know, all the time. He comes
That's
out
right.
to visit, and he's
right
next door to
me. I check
to
make sure he's behaving himself.
Exactly.
I also go over and check the stay tension on his stays all the
well,
time.
Well, he actually sailed with me once in a club race, right?
That's right. I think we won that
We
race.
Did win. Way to go.
We're looking for one good moment and one good race.
And you got two races to do it in.
We got two races to do it in, so if we get that, we're happy.
One last day, baby.
One last day. What do you got, anything different about today?
We put the secret sauce on the bottom. Probably win us a couple races today.
It's been fun. The parties have been great. Breeze has been up for most of the regatta. First day, it was a little light in the afternoon, but looking another 10 to 15 in the afternoon or the morning today, and it's just going to be a great time out there.
Everything is good, except the wind is blowing at 14, and it's coming straight from the west, which means we're going to have nothing but trouble putting these boats in the water.
It's going to be filling in real nice during the when the races start at 11. Guys got to really watch the currents, though. It's a flood tide now. It'll be low tide around 5, so the currents will be pushing them right out. But yesterday we had that big general recall because everybody was at the pin end and everybody just floated right over. Can't do that today. It's a 20% penalty. So it'll be a great start.
So day 3 here, and we've got a kind of a southwest, I guess it is, southwest. And the big problem right now currently is getting off the dock. But we think we got that figured out. And we're going to go racing, and we'll have a champion at the end of the day.
We're trying to stay ahead of the I-1 team. Well, they're sailing BH-8, but that's the two Harrys, Pete Must and Mike Dutton. So they got quite the super team there. Pete's obviously a tremendous crew, and you know, little Harry's a great driver, Mike's a great bowman. Obviously you got big Harry on there, and can't say enough about him. So they got a good team, and we're just happy to be staying in front of them so far. Every time it looks like they're buried, they climb out of magical holes. It's been pretty impressive to watch.
We were just talking strategy that we've been doing really well consistently. We don't want to change anything. We're not going to aggressively go after Jeff or anything like that because that's too high risk, you know, potentially taking ourselves out. And why change anything? Everything's going really well, and Jeff's just having the regatta of his lifetime. No one can take that away from him except himself.
We're in first right now. We're about 11 points ahead of second, and we just have to get a top 10 first race. So hopefully we can do that.
These guys are all all-stars. I'm just
you're part of the team. You're
I'm just a all-star. I'm a journeyman jib man from Barnegat Bay.
We're in a good position.
Yeah. Can you tell me about it?
It's just another day today, and we just hope to do the same thing and just stay out of trouble.
Well, we're gonna sail our own race, and yeah, hopefully the other guys don't do as well.
We have two races today, so if we have to finish in one race, in either race, seventh or better, to close it out, we could go in. So hopefully we have a good first race and we could, you know, be done with it, come in. Relax. We really wanted another race last night, so we were sailing fast again. That thunderstorm came in, so it's tough sleeping on it another night. But you know, everything feels the same. We got good breeze. Direction's a little bizarre, but should be good. Be good sailing today.
What's your gut feel, David, as far as, do you think it's going to just stay in this range? Do you think if we waited a little bit, it could come back up?
It will get lighter as the day goes on. That's my feeling.
This is not the day to be the race committee. You can put that on film. The wind's real light and real unstable, and you really need to have about 5 knots of wind to be raceable, and you want it pretty much spread across the course. And right now, this wind direction here at Little Egg is always a difficult direction. It's more or less out of the west, and I've been hearing for 2 days that if the wind comes out of the west, it's difficult, and for the last race of the regatta, that's what we've ended up with.
I haven't seen this direction ever before here, so I haven't seen a day like this before. I've seen no wind days, but never quite like this, so I don't know.
Say it's like the longest way to my life besides when my wife is in labor.
Yeah, it looks like it's filling into us.
Looking down the course, looks like you're just about to get it.
Yep.
He's about to guarantee a race win right here. He rarely does this.
Guaranteeing one?
So I don't always guarantee race wins, but I can just feel this one coming on. And you know, it's just getting stronger every second.
Yeah.
All right, well, good luck with that win, guys.
Thank you.
Taking one.
regatta.
Last day, instead of the wind being steady, we had shifts all over the place. It started off west, went to sort of, what was it, northwest or southwest?
All over.
All over.
Sometimes a little south. Sometimes a little north, and it was just very squirrely.
It was a solid regatta. I think great wind, got six races off. That's always nice. The drop always changes things, makes it interesting.
Good quality race.
Yeah,
too.
Quality, nice long beats. My legs are feeling it.
Yeah.
We ended up about 15th. It wasn't exactly the greatest start, and the first leg was kind of skewed and wasn't really set up right, and thought more people were over, so we kind of got shot out the back. No options going out left. But we ended up coming back a little bit, trucking our way up, and ended up being a decent result.
What a great, with the great regatta. I mean, it could be better here in Little Lake Harbor.
The wind settled in and we had one good race. The wind never quite came to the sea breeze because we had a front hanging over there, which is now approaching, and here we are with a hard northwest. Fortunately, everybody's in, getting hauled out, and we're done.
Yeah, we got one race in. I guess it was a 1:30 cutoff. We went out, drifted around for a little bit, give the PRO a lot of credit for not starting some sketchy races, and the breeze finally filled, and we were patient, and we got one solid race in. It's a five-legger. A lot of wind shifts. Cruise went left, went back right. It was pretty cloud-driven as well. And we had a pretty mediocre start, but we did a really good job of finding a lane and getting on port early. And we rounded the weather mark in like 8th or 9th and had a couple of really good downwinds and were able to close the gap and then take advantage on the last beat.
It was a great day of sailing. It was kind of fun with the breeze actually coming in. The first leg of that race was a little crazy, starting off with nothing and going to a whole lot. It was good, it was a little tough too, but definitely some big moves downwind and just great. Great day sailing.
Happy that we had a last race on the final day. We had our best race, so that was fun for us. Finished with a 10th that race, lost three boats right at the finish, which hurts, but made us happy that we finished with a good race. And we had a great time.
Yeah, it was the wind came up, the wind went down, it happened two or three times. Race committee made the right call by holding off, and their forecast that they got came true, and they were able to get a nice, clean race out, and it was our best race of the series, and actually we improved every day, which was a positive thing. So it's nice to leave on a higher note and makes you want to come back for more.
We got stuck in some seaweed, and we picked up some clams on the spinnaker sheet. And then the spinnaker, or the, whatever you call that thing, came out of the hole, dragging that back there, got it wrapped around the boards.
Then, did you bring cocktail sauce for the clams?
We had cocktail sauce for the clams, and it was, then we got some, and then it was, and then all of a sudden a giant squid came. And
only one race, we needed two.
We finished fifth. We couldn't pass up sailing against all these great sailors that come for this regatta. It just, we sail on the bay with just our group all year, and then we've got these people we're not gonna not sail, so it was great.
So we needed two races to have a shot at winning. We only got one because the wind took forever to fill in, and it was pretty difficult. There were some dramatic wind shifts throughout the course.
We ended up winning. It was a relief to hear they were only doing one race, so we knew we locked it up, but we still wanted to sail because we knew there was gonna be good breeze. A little tricky, a lot of shifts, a lot of lead changes, a lot of people catching up from the back, so it was pretty cool.
We needed two races, we got one.
Wish we could have gotten two races in, because that's what we needed to possibly get into the lead, but I thought we had a great regatta.
it's really overwhelming. Hasn't settled in yet, I think. In the next few days, we'll realize how well we actually sailed. We've been really close, I guess, three times now. I think we, 2009, we were 10 points away. I think 2010, we were like in it in the last race. And this year is totally different. I mean, we led from the first mark of the first race all the way through.
Well, first of all, E-Scows are such a great boat. We have a tremendous fleet. The competition is a really high level, and you know, it's hard to win. So it's really fun sailing. Everybody's really good out here.
What is there not to love about scow sailing? The boat was designed in the 30s, 20s, and it's the fastest monohull. When the wind blows, you pull the chute up. It's just, that's it.
The people around the class are just great people.
Nationals is great because it's a family atmosphere. A lot of these boats have been together for a long time, and these families have sailed against each other for years.
We have my uncle driving, Lee Almas, and then my cousin Andy Cruz on the jib, and I grew up crewing for my cousin Andy on an X-boat.
We've always been a sailing family. My dad bought a Sea Scow back in the late 50s.
My son Reese and his girlfriend are sailing with me.
I have five or six people in my family that sail E-Scows. Doug McNeil, my dad, Jerry Gill, my brother, Sam Gill, and my grandfathers both did, so Jerry Gill and Don McNeil.
Sailing with my family is fun sometimes until we get some of those
bad races.
Those bad races, and some of those bad habits from our relationship come back into play, and we.
Not often though. This
it
year.
Doesn't.
It's
yeah,
been
it
good.
Doesn't. It's been pretty good until the past week
I
or two.
I think it's actually been good for us.
Yeah. We've definitely got closer. Sailing with the family is fun.
It's the best, and that's one of the great things that this scow sailing provides is the ability to race with our kids from a really young age. You know, they can start out as fourth crews and learn what's going on, and you know, it's been really one of the greatest pleasures of my racing career is being able to get on the boat with all these kids at a young age and teach them the ropes, and then all of a sudden they get better than you. So I'm hanging out for dear life onto the sticks of this thing as long as I can, because I know they want to kick me off.
I've been sailing scow since I was probably I started fourth crewing probably when I was 7 years old for my dad. I mean, I love sailing with my family. There's no better sailing in the world than being able to compete with your family.
This is my second family boat. I started with the Lenhards, and we had it was a whole Lenhard family in me. And then afterwards, I switched over. Yeah, 25 years ago, I switched over and been with Bobby. And then Bobby got married, so we had to take Leah. And so now we're on a family boat again. Sailing with Bob's always fun. He swears a lot, yells at Leah. Leah yells at Bob. That's what we're looking for. It's a family boat.
This is my first year sailing with my dad.
Well, you grow up in it, and you just kind of grow up doing it, and you just move along. Your kids get into it. My youngest is absolutely miserable at me because she can't be here. She's got school. So I'm having to face that wrath when I get home.
Oh, it is very generational. I mean, as far as my kids sailing and stuff like that, yeah, it's a family ordeal. In our family, it is. That's for sure. My kids sailed with me in the Lightning and Snipes and all of that, and I bought this so that they could sail with me. I could snag their boyfriends too. They could pull the boards down and do that kind of silly stuff.
I've been sailing with my brother for a long time. You know, you got the, you know, the Slacks, you got the Magnos, many other families, the Porters, you know, you get absolutely the Melges team.
Yeah, there's a lot of family history here, especially including your own family there, Pete. You know, between your dad and your brother, and I'm sure your brother's son, but a lot of families here. Eric Johnson, Clay Johnson.
My son Bry is sailing with Peter Strothman along with one of my nephews, Corbett. And then I have my nephew Vincent sailing with Clifford, who is another nephew, and Coy Harrod, who's kind of like another son to me. So we've got lots of family out here. It's really fun.
My mom grew up in Matalocking sailing E-Scows, and my dad grew up in Little Egg sailing E-Scows, so they met sailing and got married. I think at Chautauqua Nationals they met or something. I don't know where. They always knew each other, but it's kind of cool. It's a tight-knit community. My boyfriend's from Bayhead, E-Scow sailor, so it's fun.
I'm getting married in 1 week. And I'm getting married to Sarah Smedley, and we met at an E-Scow regatta 50 years ago when we were 9, and here we go. So wonders never cease when you're talking about E-Scows. E-Scow sailing brings people together.
My dad, Dick Turner, who sadly passed away this past year, and he's not here, but he and Ronnie Coley and Sam Merrick and Walter Smedley and all those guys are up there just laughing and giggling about what's going on here today.